ఆదిభ్యో బ్రహ్మ విద్యా సంప్రదాయ కర్తృభ్యో వంశ ఋషుభ్యో మహద్భ్యో నమో గురుభ్యః సర్వోప్లవరహిత ప్రజ్ఞాన ఘన ప్రత్యగర్థో బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి సోహమస్మి బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి. ఓం ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైకపాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుఖే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే వెంకటేశ్వర బెస్టూ ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పరిటీ, వెల్త్ అండ్ ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ to you and your entire family members. Srimad Bhagavadgita, verse number 32 of second chapter. Let us read it. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Yadrachaya Chopapannam Swargadvarama Pavritam Sukhinah Kshatriya Partha Labhante Yuddham Idrisham. Bhagavan Krishna, he began a new topic of duty. What is duty? Because every individual, they have their own nature and duty also falls according to their nature. Now duty means it should fill both aspects, your inner growth and the welfare of the entire cosmos, universe. Now you should select something as your living field that should give inner growth with happiness and that should not disturb outer sources, and it should also help as sun, rivers, air, they help to the cosmos. That is the technical. For that you need to be a proper structured person. In order to give that infrastructure psychologically, physically, we need to have a proper educational system. That educational system alone has the structure of Varna Ashrama Dharmam. As we saw in the last session, these words are completely misunderstood. Even now, there are more people who interpret wrongly, mostly misinterpreted. Now, the need of this Varnashrama Dharma is for proper growth of every individual. You know, a human being, a man should get a proper growth, man or woman. They should get proper growth means what? They should reach their completeness. At the same time, man has the responsibility to take care of all the creatures around him. Is that responsibility must be given to all the youngsters. Means that responsibility cannot be given from outside. He should take the charge of responsibility. Therefore, we need to have proper system. Varna means Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Sudra. And the division, these divisions are to get more clarity about one's own nature, to judge, to select his duty. Okay? The way he can live a life, it gives clarity to select the field through which he can survive happily. He can get that adequacyness. You know what is that adequacyness? There is no word adequacyness, okay? I make it Purnatvam. Contentment. When you grow, that growth itself contentment. Like when you put a flower sapling, so when it brings, you know, the buds, that flower, birds, and whatever that raw like a fruit, when in ripe fruit, all the part it has endowed with completeness. A tree means it should give fruit. That tree has become completeness. It serves the humanity. It also survives and serves the humanity. Do we have that kind of life? This Varnashrama Dharma is to help to get complete life. Now we saw Varna Dharma. Varna Dharma means the division, why it was and according to which norms we divide. That's what we saw in the last session. Now here Ashrama Dharma means what? Ashrama Dharma is, we call it four, there are four, Brahmacharya, Grihastha, Vanaprastha and Sannyasa. And people may think that Swamiji, this entire era has changed. You need not bring this ancient system of divisions, it won't help. No, still, after even crores of years, this human being should eat only through mouth, should breathe through nose alone. Nothing will change. Your sleep won't change. Maybe the time and quantity and quality of these things may change, but your experience about you never changes. Now you see the society which is endowed with lots of confusion, loaded with lots of fear. Imagine if there is a society which doesn't have confusion, which is not loaded with unnecessarily fears and focused, then happiest society it would be forever. That's our responsibility. Brahmacharya means endowed with a proper person, to get contacted with a proper person. A proper person means what? Who knows the reality of everything? He knows the reality about your physical, psychological system and your urges, your wishes, and he also is aware about the world, what it can give it to you. Therefore, he also knows how to teach you about the world and how to prepare yourself for the life. This Brahmachari should be kept somewhere away from the public. That was the rules of a Gurukula which we had in ancient time. These Gurukulas should not be affected or interrupted by the public, means the society. The society, it includes, you know, it involves so many aspects. The society is the place which threatens you. And people are likes and dislikes. Society is full of cunningness, cheating each other. A young child, in the childhood, it should have a proper environment. No threatening, no deviation, not having any opportunity to lose his body's concentration. It should be given as the garbhavasa. That garbhavasa, when that infant it was in the womb of mother, it had a very secured environment. In the same way, this child after age of 5, it has to be sent to a guru who can take care of his growth. Because many time parents lose, you know, the what to be given to this child. It should not be in that way. Because of love, you give more. You give more means what? you may spoil his growth. That's what the fact is. Therefore, our forefathers, they used to have Kulapati, Gurukula, and they used to send there all the children. Those children will be there for 25 years, up to his 25th year old age. He will get complete growth, first inner growth. He will be taught who he is really. The real nature will be informed first. When you are informed, you are a birthless, deathless, and you are everywhere, then the complete perception changes about the life. And given the supreme knowledges like the secret of karma, and secret of dharma, secret of brahma, all this knowledge, when it gives, it is given to a young person, so he could observe and assimilate under the guidance of a guru, it would be marvelous to have a healthy society. It was the purpose for this division. First 25 years just to be endowed with educational system, that too with guru. That was the system which we had. And not only that, when he studies, he is preparing his ability, he will get inner peace. That inner peace may not be disturbed by the society's cunningness, vengeance, or likes and dislikes, nothing. He will be more stronger. He will be given materialistic knowledge and spiritual knowledge. Both, it gives a complete personality. That's the goal of Brahmacharya Ashrama. They call it Ashrama. Ashrama means what? You give an entire different environment. This Brahmacharya Ashrama means, now they translate as a bachelor. Bachelor, it doesn't mean Brahmacharya. Brahmacharya means to be endowed with Brahma Vidya, to be endowed with Vedas, to be endowed with Guru, and to be with Ishvara. That's what Brahmacharya Ashrama is. Now, that's our responsibility of all the householders, means Grihasthas, to provide that kind of environment to our children. Do we do that? No. No opportunity even. No. No opportunity means what? This individual cannot make a decision. There are colleges. They have to send their children to the colleges. But if we have prayer, we will get the same environment which we had in ancient time. The next is, after 25 years, with the guidance of Guru, he comes to the society. Now he gets married. When he gets married, from that point, he becomes eligible for all dharma karya. He can perform puja, he can be a yajamana. You know, to be an yajamana. Yajamana means what, you know? An author of a homa. He can get it done, homas, pujas, yajnas. He can construct all this temple, etc. They need to be married. Still, in Chidambaram, see, married person alone can enter into Garbhagraha. You should be married. A married people are respected, reputed even by our scriptures. This householder, he should earn money and he should take care of himself and he should take care of his family and he should take care of the welfare of the society and he should provide food for Brahmachari and he should also provide food for Vanaprastha and Sannyasis. Therefore, this Grihastha householder has got a tremendous responsibility. We call them duty. Those duties must be taken with complete responsibility. There where Arjuna, you go wrong. That's what he says. These Grihasthas are the backbone of entire society. They are the foundation of the society. They can run a temple, they can run all kinds of rituals of Vedas, they can also go for studies. 25 years, you know. When they get their children, they have to send those children to the Gurukula. When their children are back, they should get away. Get away means withdrawing from the responsibility, not being having a thought of burden. No. Positively handing it over. Handing it over means giving up all the assets to their children. It's a positive retirement. Means we can say VRS. VRS means what? Voluntary retirement. And to be endowed with study, not to gappa marna. Not to have or spend time for gossiping about others. No. To be endowed with what? Himself. Inner journey. From that point, inner journey begins. They used to live the forest which is nearby. Now there is no forest. Therefore what? In the house itself we can have the system of just, you know, withdrawing. But they will be as the backbone for the society, means a family. They will be like a margadarshak, a kind of what I can say, a guide, a proper guide. This proper guide, like a, you know, pilot and like a captain of the ship. Now he can be away a little bit as a witness. Whenever they need, he can guide. That guidance also, what? It has to be governed by Shastra. Spending more time with himself, preparing to renounce. To renounce the world. Because the body is a boat. After crossing the river, if you like the body, means if you like the boat, and boat wala come and will say that, please get away. In the same way, the boat wala who has given this boat as a rent, he will come in a day. Before that, you prepare yourself, get ready positively. Therefore, this third stage is very important. So, unless until you have maturity, you cannot do it. Because the mind which is loaded with fear, it won't leave this materialistic world. You cannot do it. That voluntarily if you plug, there will be pain. Therefore, the chaos made. We penetrate into others' duty because of what? Lack of clarity. Therefore, this grihastha and vanaprastha, they have to be perfect. Then sannyasa. After 25 years, it's norm. Say, having and assuming, you know, assuming as though human being, they are going to live for 100 years. After 25 years, not only 25 years, before that also you can make a sannyasa. You can renounce everything. You can. Nobody will force. That renunciation, it has got its own glory. But renunciation should happen from inside, not from outside. Okay? These are the divisions of ashrama. Therefore, we call it ashrama dharma. Now, you are not a brahmachari. You are not a vanaprasthi. And you are not a sannyasi. You are a householder. That to a king of all householders, grihasthas. You should not do or commit mistake, Arjuna. You should take the responsibility. Idrachayacha upapannam swargadvaram apavritam. It says, this battle is the gate of swarga for you. Because Kshatriya, when he fights, after, you know, when he fights and when he loses his life, he will be renowned in swarga. And even people, old people, should respect, we have to respect. Therefore, in daily prayers, our Pujya Swamiji have taught us, we have to thank to these soldiers of armies. That army, navy, our air force, we have to thank them. Because they are the legends, they are the real karma yogi kshatriyas. No matter what jati or what community they are, but they are kshatriyas. And kshatriyas' duty is to protect dharma. They become God, they become Ishvara. We worship them, we respect them in the form of worship. Therefore, the sukhinaha kshatriyaha, a proper kshatriya, won't lose this chance because you got the, luckily you got this chance, don't lose it. Because this kind of battle is very rare to get because this is known as a dharma yuddham. That's what he said in the verse number 32. We'll go to next verse. Atha cetvam imam dharmyam sangramam na karishyasi tata swadharmam kirtincha hitva papam avapsi. Arjuna, definitely you are going to commit a blunder if you quit now. Because two kinds of mistakes will be there when you quit, when you escape. What is that? Swadharma tyagaha. He says, imam dharmyam sangramam na karishyasi. If you won't fight, tata swadharmam kirtincha, you will just quit your dharma and even you are going to be away from all the kirtis, means all this name and fame, everything which you have already. You are going to be thrown out away from that. Not only that, you will also be affected by papa. He was telling that by killing I would get papa. But here, there is something different. If you don't fight, you will be affected by papa. That's what dharma. Dharma needs to be interpreted according to the context. From this verse onward, he will talk about Arjuna's repetition and finally the Krishna is pinching more and more and more, giving heavier dose. This is not only for Arjuna, for us even to get clarity. To get clarity means what? To have a beautiful society. And we can also think about our family members and our life, because once we were, if we would have been given this clarity when we were young, our life would have been something more beautiful. I'm not saying that now it's not beautiful, because when you start studying Shastra, you are fortunate enough. So I'm very sure about it. We will continue the study from next episode tomorrow. Hari Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harih Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harih Om. Om Namo Narayanaya. Now